Yes. Friends, are you all there? Should we start? Yes, we will start the session with the chantings of Tri Omkar, requesting you all to sit with your spine erect, keep your shoulders proper, keep your chin parallel to the floor, just allow your whole body to settle down. Let us go ahead and chant Tri Omkar. Slowly inhale. Gently open your eyes. Yes. Last session, we ended the session with the discussion about Ishwar as that sutra number 24 says, Klesha Karma Vipaka Ashay Aparamrishtaha, untouched by, and that is Purusha Vishesha Ishwaraha. So Ishwar is that special Purusha who is untouched by all this klesha, karma, vipaka, ashaya or karmashaya. Now, friends, in the second chapter, as we will be going ahead, we will be understanding that the purpose of the prakriti, as the shloka says, I don't know the number now, I'm not recollecting. But bhoga apavarga artham drishyam. Drishyam is nothing but prakriti. Bhoga, prakriti is giving experience. Apavarga, it is also taking you towards moksha or liberation, you can say. So prakriti is the means to take you towards purusha, friends. We need to understand. There are many individual Purushas, and this individual Purusha, through yoga, they will go through the worldly pleasures, or not to say pleasures actually, worldly experiences, bhoga. Pleasures are also experiences, no doubt. But pleasures sometimes are taken as more involvement into the, you know, deep understanding of prakriti. So yogic practices will transform you from worldly experiences, that is bhoga, and using this bhoga itself as means for freedom, that is apavarga. Jaise ki, for awareness, we have been initiated many techniques by our teachers, by our guru, isn't it? जैसे कि आशा मैम ने एक बार भगवत गीता के क्लास में कहा था कि गुरुजी यूज टू से, डॉक्टर साहब यूज टू से दैट बी अवेयर एट एवरी मोमेंट, व्हाट एवर यू आर गोइंग टू डू, थिंक अबाउट इट, वेदर इट इज राइट, वेदर इट इज गुड, और वेदर इट इज बैड, और वेदर इट इज रॉन्ग. The moment you are thinking about that action, you will find that there are inner energies which are preventing you from going into that. So when Dr. Saab makes us to understand that aspect, it is like a little effort to become more aware, isn't it? So we are into the day-to-day actions, but that's making us more aware. Okay, where we are going towards apavarga. We are going towards getting rid of those which we are not supposed to experience. So here, I would go ahead and say, the great Rishi Munis, even the great Kapila Muni, he was not born free as such. And we all, as we come to this birth, we are not free. Or we are not the one who have attained freedom and we are coming to this state of human body. Rather, after following a particular spiritual path, we are getting freedom. So we all are the other Purushas, as I want to explain you and make you understand. Whereas when we talk about Ishvara as a special Purusha, is ever free. He neither had any bondages in the past, nor there is any possibility of having it in the future. He is eternal, he is omniscient, he is beyond time and space. In Vyasa Bhashya, it is said, only the Agamaha Pramana, or you can say the scriptures, only the scriptures are the proof of the existence of Ishvara. In fact, from where have these scriptures originated, friends? These scriptures have come to us from God Himself. Since He is the source of all the knowledge. In the 25th and the 26th Sutra, Patanjali Muni has emphasized that no other Purusha can equal or surpass the greatness of Ishvara by going through this sutra, Tatra Nirashti Shayam Sarvajna Bijam. Sarvajna Bijam, seed of omniscience. Tatra, in him. Niratishayam, always. There is always this word used, unsurpassed. No one has overtaken it. Will not be able to. Our effort is to surpass the Prakruti and reach to that level of consciousness or Purusha. But here, with this explanation, Tatra Niratishayam, Sarvajna, Ishvara is the highest understanding of omniscience or highest limit of omniscience. Ishvara is the very source of this highest knowledge. He can know everything at any time, every moment. All the things are known to him very clearly about the whole creation, I should say. जैसे मैं लास्ट टाइम भी कह रहा था कि हम कहते हैं ना एक पत्ता भी उसकी इजाजत के बिना हिलता नहीं, नॉट इवन अ ब्लेड ऑफ ग्रास और अ ब्लेड ऑफ लीफ विल मूव विदाउट हिज नॉलेज. एवरीथिंग इज देयर इन हिज अंडरस्टैंडिंग. एंड द सेम थिंग इज एम्फसाइज्ड इन द नेक्स्ट सूत्र बाय टेलिंग अस स पूर्वे शाम अपि. पूर्वे शाम अपि गुरुहु काले नानवच्छेदा कालेन अनवच्छेदा. बियॉन्ड टाइम, ही इज बियॉन्ड टाइम. इन फैक्ट ईश्वर इज द मास्टर. गुरुहु पूर्वे शाम अपि, He is the master of all the previous masters. Here, all the great masters who have imparted the knowledge to mankind, they were all limited by time, isn't it? Earlier to the Ashtanga Hriday, we were going through Hatapradipika, we were going through Bhagavad Gita, maybe Swatmaram Suri, maybe Veda Vyasa, who has written down the Mahabharata, the Bhagavad Gita, which comes to us in the form of words through the mouth of Lord Krishna. So here, whether it is Lord Krishna, Lord Rama, or maybe Maharshi Kapila, Buddha, Mahavir, all the great masters, whoever has descended on this world and inspired thousands to walk on this spiritual path, they made, or they, I should say, they molded our lives. They inspired us so that we can carry on this spiritual work on this spiritual path. So because of their influence, because of their guidance, we are on this. So they are the masters, no doubt about it. They are the people who brought the knowledge in front of us. But who is the first one? Ishvara, the eternal one, without any beginning or end. So he is the ultimate source of knowledge for all these masters also. He is the master at present also. He will be the master in the future also. Because it is said, Kalena Anvachedar. He is beyond time. He is not bounded by time and space. He is beyond this. As all this thing is said, friends, हमारे मन में आता है ना कि चलो ठीक है, how to get connect with this Ishwar, how to know this Ishwar, how to gain a proximity to this Ishwar, how to have a feeling of essence of this Ishwar. Immediately Patanjali Muni goes ahead and talks about the identification of Ishwar, the designation of Ishwar, and he says in the 27th sutra, tasya vachakah pranavah. Pranava means Om, Vachakaha, designation. So his designation is nothing but Pranavaha, the mystic syllable, Om. So here, friends, Pranava is like representing Ishwara, just as a name for every other person. My name is Sabir. Your name is Mr. Ashutosh, Dr. Ashutosh, Dr. Sunil, Asha Madam. We all have our name. This is, what is this? This is representing us. So here we can say, and when we call someone, we call by their name, addressing with respect, Mr., Mrs., Doctor, adding those prefix in the very similar manner, friends. Om is the name of that Ishwar. Uttering Om can invoke him. Haven't come across a single case who has in the last 20 years might have told me, I do not enjoy chanting Om. There were many reluctant Muslims, Christians coming to my class. Sabirji, why do you chant Om? I say, I need not answer. You also start chanting, you will get the answer, because I don't know the answer. Kon maganbari kare unko samjhane ke liye jaye? Ek kaam karo, tum bhi chanting karo. Tumko pasand aaya to karte raho, nahi pasand aaya to chhod do na bhai. Isne tumko zabardasti kiya. हम तो ना नहीं, हम तो करना ही चाहिए, हमारे क्लास में आया तो नहीं चलेगा, नहीं करेंगे, ऐसा तो है नहीं. When they used to ask, why is it so that whenever we chant Om, we feel like keeping on chanting it? I just tell them, see, my mother used to call me Sabu. My elder sister, who has a child who is 6 months older than me. Huh? Yes, my elder sister has her first child who is 6 months older than me. अब पहले के जमाने में ऐसे ही होता था. तो शी यूज टू कॉल मी ढेपू. ढेपू मतलब गुड़ का ढेकला. हु इज वेरी स्वीट. आप कैसा है, कोई किसी नाम से पुकारता है, कोई किसी नाम से पुकारता है, कोई किसी नाम से पुकारता है. तो अगर मैं ओम बोलूं तो मुझे अच्छा लगता है. तुमको कोई और नाम से पुकारा तो किसने मना किया भाई, पुकारो. व्हाट इज देयर. तो इन दिस प्रैक्टिकल लाइफ वी कैन से वी कैन बी एड्रेस्ड बाय एनी नेम्स एंड इन द वेरी सिमिलर मैनर प्रैक्टिकली द वे यू अंडरस्टैंड योर गॉड यू कैन कॉल हिम बाय दैट नेम. नोबडी इज स्टॉपिंग यू. एंड यू शुड ऑल्सो अंडरस्टैंड आवर नेम मे बी समटाइम्स अलॉन्ग विथ सरनेम मिडल नेम बिकम्स अवर सिग्नेचर. आप बैंक में भी अगर कभी पैसा वसूल करने जाएंगे तो वो बोलता है तुम यही है, वो साइन करके बताओ. इजंट इट, ही विल नॉट गिव मनी अनलेस वी साइन अवर चेक एंड आस्क फॉर मनी. तो प्रैक्टिकल पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू इन द वेरी सिमिलर मैनर वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू गेट कनेक्ट विथ दैट गॉड वी नीड टू डू हैव सम काइंड ऑफ सिग्नेचर कनेक्शन विथ हिम. सो मेडिटेशन ऑन ओम इज लिटरली लाइक गेटिंग कनेक्टेड एंड डूइंग दैट सिग्नेचर एंड बिकमिंग मोर एंड मोर प्रॉक्सिमिटी टू दैट अल्टीमेट नॉलेज. वेन वी से ईश्वर हु इज फॉर्मलेस एट्रीब्यूटलेस बियॉन्ड टाइम वी से वन कैनॉट कम्युनिकेट विथ ईश्वर. बट एट द सेम टाइम आई वुड लाइक टू मेक इट वेरी क्लियर हियर दिस मिस्टिक सिलेबल ओम दिस वन ऑफ द अल्टीमेट ग्रेटेस्ट ऑफ द मंत्रास इज द की टू ओपन द डोर फॉर डिवाइन कॉन्शियसनेस. व्यास भाष्य हैज ऑल्सो पॉइंटेड आउट दैट द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन दी ओम एंड ईश्वर इज जस्ट नॉट मियरली कन्वेंशनल. वेरी क्लियरली सेज दैट इट इज इटर्नल. रिलेशन बिटवीन ओम एंड ईश्वर इज लाइक दैट ऑफ लैम्प एंड लाइट. बिटवीन लाइक ए मदर एंड सन. एंड यू नो दिस काइंड ऑफ एक्सप्लेनेशन हैज बीन गिवन इन सो मेनी उपनिषद्स एज द अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ एब्सोल्यूट रियलिटी ब्रह्मन इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय ओम. दिस ओम इज एक्सेप्टेड बाय ऑल रिलीजियस कल्ट्स इन इंडिया बाय ऑल रिलीजियस फॉलोइंग्स हिंदूज जैन्स सिख and even Buddhists who do not accept God as a principle, they also accept Om. So there is something in it, isn't it? Even the Bible, once I was listening to the lecture in a conference, and there was a father who came to, it was a religious understanding of knowing the ultimate energy. So father went on to explain a beautiful concept there, and he said in it said in Bible that in the beginning of the world there was only one word, and that word was supposed to be connected with God, or I should say that that word was God. his understanding of that word being God, what is that word? And you see in every prayer, as a sentence is made as a request and to be fulfilled, the word Amen comes in. Amen. In Muslims, in Islam, it is Ameen. So when we say Ameen, Alif, Meem, Noon, that Noon is Na, Meem is Ma, and Alif is connecting you with A, though U is not there in that. But there are certain surah in Quran where even it starts, the surah starts with Alif, Waw, Meem. Means Alif is A, Waw is U. Hum usko shabdo, apna akshar ke andar usko Waw kehte hain, but it is actually U. And then there is Ma. So Alif, Waw, Meem. To ye dekha jaye to aksharon ka koi arth to hai nahi. But at the same time, ये तीनों को मिलाकर कहीं ऐसा तो नहीं कि नाम रख दिया. एक बार गुरुजी रामायण का कंसेप्ट बता रहे थे तो उन्होंने एक बहुत अच्छी बात कही थी, which I will never forget in my life. When Ram along with his Vanar Sena was going in today's day, that place is known as Rameshwaram. In southern India. So from Rameshwaram to Sri Lanka, as they decided to build a bridge across the sea, the monkeys used to lift big, big stones, and Guruji used to say, I don't know how far this thing is the fact as per the scriptures, but Guruji, while making me understand, he used to say the monkeys used to lift the stone and say Jai Shri Ram and throw it into the sea. What used to happen? The stone used to float on the water. The stone, by just saying Jai Shri Ram, used to float up. Now Lord Rama was watching all these things. Oh no, somewhere a tinge of ego might have got erupted in Rama, where he might have thought ki ye bandar log agar mera naam leke agar kabhi ये पत्थर को फेंकते हैं तो ये फ्लोट होने लगता है. श्योरली इट विल फ्लोट इफ आई एम ऑल्सो थ्रोइंग इट बिकॉज इट इज माई नेम इज़न्ट इट. ही लिफ्टेड वन एंड थ्रू इट, इट ड्राउंड, इट डिड नॉट फ्लोट. तो अगले ही सूत्र में पतंजलि मुनि कहते हैं कि भैया ये जो ओम है ये खाली ऐसे ही नाम लेने से चलेगा नहीं. तत् जपस तदर्थ भावनम, तत् जप तद अर्थ भावनम. सो द ओल्डेस्ट अमंग द मंकीज और द लीडर, आई डोंट नो हु ही वाज, हिज नेम वाज जांबू वन और समथिंग लाइक दैट. ही वाज द वाइसेस्ट अमंग ऑल द मंकीज. ही वाज ऑब्जर्विंग ऑल दिस थिंग, राम डूइंग दैट एंड हिज स्टोन गेटिंग ब्राउन. He approached Rama and said with a beautiful smile on his face, My Lord, your name is more powerful than yourself. So, here it becomes very clear that rather than trying to understand Klesha, Karma, Vipaka and Karmashai to know the Purusha Vishesh as Ishwara, let us be into that enjoyment of Pranava. Let us keep on chanting Om, which will lead us to the ultimate state. Here, Patanjali Muni comes in front of us, telling us Tatah or Tat Jap Tad Artha Bhavanam. Tat Japah is nothing but its repetition. Tad artha, meditating upon its meaning. So just imagine, not only you are doing the repetition of the mantra, but also understanding the meaning and completely focused on it. And since Om represents Ishvara, while chanting Om, one must meditate on Ishvara. One should feel that he is invoking Ishvara. So Om Japa, as it is said to be a very powerful spiritual practice to realize Ishvara or God, the Nama Japa is very important. The Nama Smarana is very important. And friends, in every religion, whether it is Islam, whether it is Christianity, this Nama Smarana, Nama Japa is taken as a very highly potent practice. Every religion, you take any religion. So when Lord's name is repeated with awareness at all the times, the devotee goes beyond his egoistic consciousness related to Nama Rupa with relation to the material world. And what remains is the only reality, that is the ultimate Ishvara. Sometimes, friends, this kind of chanting of Om becomes mechanical also. Not to name anyone, but I have seen people, they are having mala in their hands. I had been to one Kirana shop, and he was continuously letting the beads to go on, and he was doing japa also. So I was just observing him. People were coming and asking, ye kaise diya, ye kaise diya. So usne bola, ye 10 rupee kilo, ye 15 rupee kilo, ye 50 rupee kilo. And he was continuously counting the beads. I was wondering whether he is literally taking the name with that dedication, or he is just simply counting the beads over there. Is it mechanical or something like that? I did not went on to ask this fellow. कुछ दिनों के बाद में गुरुजी से बहुत हिम्मत बना के मैंने पूछा, सर, आई हैव सीन दिस पीपल, दे आर कैरिंग अ बैग एंड इन दैट बैग इज दिस माला एंड दे कीप ऑन चैंटिंग एंड दे डू ऑल एक्टिविटीज थ्रू आउट द डे, इज दैट ऑल्सो नाम जप? तो ही सेट, साबिर, ये सब के ऊपर हमको तर्क वितर्क करने का हक किसी ने नहीं दिया. वैसे तुम्हारे दिमाग में ये बात आ रहा होगा कि जैसे कोई मुंह में चीविंग गम रखकर चबा रहा हो, वैसे नाम जप कर रहा हो. यू मे बी थिंकिंग लाइक दैट. सो ही वाज स्लाइटली यू नो टेकन अबैक बाय दिस क्वेश्चन एंड ही आस्क्ड कि व्हाई डोंट यू लीव इट टू देमसेल्स. ये उनका कर्म है, वो जाने. हु आर वी टू टॉक अबाउट दिस? आई सेड, सर, जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू नो कि वेदर देयर डेडिकेशन इज देयर इन इट. वी कैन नॉट जज, वी शुड नॉट बिकम जजमेंटल ओवर हियर, ही सेड इन अ वेरी क्लियर मैनर. सो नेवर पॉइंट एट एनी पीपल हाउ दे आर डूइंग इट, हाउ यू आर डूइंग दैट मैटर्स मोस्ट.
Sabir bhai,
जी
just a small story to share here.
प्लीज प्लीज.
It so happened कि एक आश्रम के बाहर जो शिष्य लोग थे, तो एक शिष्य जो है वो धूम्रपान कर रहा था, स्मोकिंग, एंड वाइल इन अ काइंड ऑफ अ मेडिटेटिव पोज पर स्मोक कर रहा था. तो बाकी शिष्य जो देखे, अरे ये क्या कर रहा है, ये तो बहुत गड़बड़ बात है. तो वो उनसे जाके चैलेंज किए कि भाई ये क्या कर रहे हो तुम, ये सैक्रिलेज, तुम बने आश्रम के बाहर स्मोकिंग कर रहे हो मेडिटेशन के दौरान. तो बोले, नहीं, इसमें क्या बात है, कोई बुराई नहीं है. बोले, नहीं, ये तो तुमने भ्रष्ट कर दिया, ये वो हम गुरु जी से आके बोलेंगे. तो गुरु जी को एक गए गुरु जी के पास कि गुरु जी, हमें आपसे एक चीज पूछनी है. गुरु जी, इज इट ओके टू स्मोक वाइल मेडिटेटिंग? तो गुरु जी सेड, नो, इट इज नॉट गुड एट ऑल, इट ऑट नॉट टू बी डन. तो बोलो, क्यों, लेकिन क्यों पूछ रहे हो तुम? तो बोले कि नहीं, वो फला फला शिष्य जो है, वो हमने स्मोकिंग करते देखा बाहर, उसको इसने पूछ रहे थे. अच्छा, बुलाओ उसको. तो बुलाया उसको. तो वो आके पूछा, भाई क्या बात है सर. गुरु जी, पहले 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 मेरे को आपसे एक प्रश्न पूछना है. दैट गुरु जी, इज इट ओके टू मेडिटेट वाइल स्मोकिंग? इट इज, यस, ऑफ कोर्स, इट्स परफेक्टली ओके. सो जस्ट टू इलस्ट्रेट व्हाट यू सेड, कि एक्सटर्नली अपन को जज नहीं करना चाहिए. बिल्कुल, इट इज द भावना विच मैटर्स. सो
यस यस वेरी मच. एंड टू सेकेंड योर थॉट्स, द ग्रेट साई बाबा एज वेल एज संत श्री गजानन महाराज, यस, व्हेन दे यूज्ड टू स्मोक चीलम. साई बाबा का तो ऐसा उनके गाथा में लिखा हुआ है कि व्हेन ही यूज्ड टू रिलीज द स्मोक, वो स्मोक का कभी ओम का आकार बने तो कभी अल्लाह का आकार बने. अभी आप अल्लाह जो लिखा हुआ रहता है उर्दू में या अरबी में अगर आप पढ़ेंगे तो उसके जो कर्स हैं और वो जो है ना ओम से बहुत मिलते जुलते हैं. ओम के मतलब बहुत नहीं, 99% मिलते जुलते हैं. खाली इतना है कि वो वर्टिकल को हॉरिजॉन्टल करना है आपको. अगर आपको ओम को, ओम को अगर आपने वर्टिकल जो है वो शेप को ऐसे हॉरिजॉन्टल कर दिया और वो जो नीचे का जो उसका जो चंद्र और बिंदु ऊपर कर दिया तो यू विल सी दैट इट इज नथिंग बट अल्लाह. सी दिस इज द ब्यूटी ऑफ मेकिंग इट एक्सप्लेनिंग टू पीपल के हाउ यू अंडरस्टैंड. एंड इन अवर Upanishads also, I do not remember, I think it in Mundaka Upanishad only, because in Shvetashvatara Upanishad mein bhi shayad ye bataya gaya hai, ke you have to understand Om like a bow. Om is like a bow, self is the arrow, myself, the arrow, the self in me, the arrow, and Brahman is to be taken as the target. So Om is like, you know, as Bhagavad Gita says, is a journey through the self, to the self, by the self. So the same concept is beautifully explained in Upanishads also. Kai tarike hain samajhne ke aur samjhane ke. All said and done, one should also know what literally pranava means. In Sanskrit, pranavaha literally means intense prayer. Or you can say pranavaha also means a vehicle which is moving with great speed. But where it is heading to? Which leads to God. So pranava sadhana or omkar meditation means like intense prayer to reach the Lord, to reach the Ishwara, where you are completely surrendering your me, mine, everything. And you know, friends, kyunki ek bahut important topic hai, and since we are belonging to academic backgrounds, it becomes very important how to do this Omkara Japa. One way it is said, Vaikari Madhyama Pashyanti Vani. Vaikari is loudly, Madhyama medium pitch, and Pashyanti is like audible to your own ears. There is another way of understanding the same concept in Vachika Upaunshu Manasika. This Vachika Japa is like loud chanting, Upaunshu, whispering sound, and Mansika, mental chanting of the same. These three will lead to the fourth, and that is Ajapa Japa. Ajapa Japa kya hai? A natural, spontaneous, automatic chanting of Om effortlessly taking place throughout. So when we say Vachika to Upaunshu, Upaunshu to Manasika, and this three will lead you. The succeeding type of japa is like, you know, 1,000 times better than the previous one. Upaunshu is 1,000 times better than Vachika. Manasika is 1,000 times better than Upaunshu. And when you talk about a japa japa, you can always say that, yes, this is what you are supposed to come to. Every breath is accompanied by Om in that Ajapa Japa. In fact, if one comes into it and gets settled into it, in sleep also, you will find that person chanting Om. These three matras, somewhere you will find as moras. Moras and matras are one and the same thing. A, O, Ma. And the Adha matra of Nad, Na, which follows after the chanting of Ma, takes one to the ultimate state of silence. So, according to one of the scriptures, it is said that these three matras are the three principles of the universe, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesha, which are concerned about creation, sustenance, and destruction. So while meditating and doing the chantings of Om, we need to understand A, O, Ma, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesha. Brahma, in some text you will find as Jagrut Avastha, in some text you will find Swapna Avastha. And Vishnu, the same thing. Some text will call it as Jagrut, some text will call it as Swapna. Whereas Mahesha is always Sushupti. So creation, sustenance, and destruction, as we have understood this in Bhagavad Gita also. But here these three, which are leading to the Adha Matra of Nadana, when we are meditating, it is like taking one beyond all these three states into the fourth state, and that is known as Turiya. The state of super consciousness. And it has been found, not only found, but scientifically proven, that even the single chanting of A, O, and Makara, one can lead himself into that state of silence, which actually follows what you are doing. And you know, when we are chanting the repetitions of Om, after completion of one chant and before the start of the next one, there is a gap of silence between the two. And this silence is like, you know, like suspension of breath. There is no functioning of your thought processes or anything like that. No mind functioning. This is the beauty of Om. Even it is connected to Sattva, Raja, Tama. Brahma, the Sattva, Raja, the Vishnu, and Tama as Mahesha. So, Prakruti, the three forces of Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh belonging to Prakruti are the very reason through this Omkar to lead you beyond them into that oneness with that super consciousness. And you know what Patanjali says? If you are into this, he says, Tataha. Thereby, because of this practice of Om in a very regular manner, Satyaka Chetana Adhigamaha Apiyantaraya Abhavascha. It is like Pratyaka Chetana means we will go beyond Parang Chetana. Now, friends, in today's scenario, we are all externally oriented. We are connected with the so many things related to continuous interaction of the body, mind, senses with the external environment. And from such kind of interaction, we are developing that sense of me, mine. We are getting connected to our relatives. We are having friends. We are having foes. We are connected to society. All these things, friends, are making us to forget us, the self within. Hamare andar jo self reside karta hai, usko hum connect hi nahi kar pa rahe. तो हियर एज वी सी प्रत्यक चेतना इज ऑपोजिट टू दैट ऑफ पारांग चेतना. पारांग चेतना मीन्स एक्सटर्नल, प्रत्यक चेतना मीन्स इंटरनल प्रत्यक. सो अवर कॉन्शियसनेस टर्न्स इनवर्ड एंड व्हाट हैपेंस अंतराया अभावश्च अभावः. अभाव मीन्स इट इज लाइक द ऑब्स्टेकल्स आर गेटिंग वैनिश्ड. अंतराया का मतलब होता है ऑब्स्टेकल्स, इंपेडिमेंट्स. So here we are finding two advantages of practicing pranava japa. The first one is turning of the consciousness inward, that is pratyeka chetana, means internal awareness towards the self within. The second advantage which we are getting here is the removal of the obstacles, or you can say vanishing of the obstacles by being on the path of yoga. What are these obstacles is explained in the next sutra. But here this concept becomes very important in today's scenario by making the other person understand you are having problems in your life. Okay, fine, just do om chanting. Wo bolta hai humko khali om chanting karne se kaam ho jayega. Kaam tab hoga jab tum dil laga kar karoge, dedicatedly karoge, puri dridhta ke sath mein, vishwas ke sath mein karoge. Unless and until you bring this vishwas in your practice or repetition of the chanting of om, you may not be seeing the results. Just do it and you will find it happening. So friends, by nature itself we are outward oriented, and that is the reason that we are not seeing the self within. It literally requires lot of courage from an individual to turn his vision within, to know that eternal self. And that's what is being told, that these are the 9 obstacles which we need to keep in our mind and overcome them. Let us go and understand them in detail. If we see the next sutra, it is about chitta vikshepa. Vyadhi styan samshaya pramad alasya avirati bhranti darshana alabdh bhumikatva अनवस्थी तत्वानि चित्त विक्षेपास्ते अंतराया. व्याधि डिजीज, स्थान इज लाइक डलनेस और यू कैन से मेंटल लेजीनेस, संशय इज डाउट, प्रमाद यू कैन से प्रोक्रास्टिनेशन और केयरलेसनेस, आलस्य physical laziness you can go ahead say, and or say simple laziness, avirati. See, virati is detached, av is not able to detach, that means in attachment. So avirati is literally attachment. Bhranti darshan, you can say erroneous perception, or you can also say delusion. That's why the perception is becoming erroneous. ये delusion की भाषा को हमने भगवत गीता में मोह के रूप में कितनी अच्छी तरह से समझा, जबकि हमने सेकंड चैप्टर के उस श्लोक में ध्यायतो विषयान पुंसः संगस्तेषु उपजायते, द 62nd श्लोक ऑफ द सेकंड चैप्टर ऑफ भगवत गीता, संगात संजायते कामः कामात क्रोध अभिजाय क्रोधात भवति सम्मोह. सो देयर इटसेल्फ ही सेज इफ यू आर इन दैट रेज एग्रेशन इट विल लीड टू मोह, मोहात स्मृति विभ्रंश, स्मृति भ्रंशात बुद्धि नाशो, बुद्धि नाशात प्रणश्यति. तो अब देखो यहां पर भी दिया हुआ है भ्रांति दर्शन द मोह पार्ट. अलब्ध भूमिकत्व इज नॉट एबल टू अटेन अ हायर स्टेट. सी, वी ऑल आर प्रैक्टिकल स्टूडेंट्स, वी वॉन्ट टू डू शीर्षासन ऑल्सो. सम ऑफ यू विल से इट इज कॉन्ट्राइंडिकेटेड फॉर मी, साबिर भाई के जैसा, एंड यू विल नॉट डू इट. बट सम ऑफ यू विल से ठीक है, मे बी कॉन्ट्राइंडिकेटेड, बट लेट मी गिव इट अ ट्राई, इफ इट इज ट्रबलिंग आई विल नॉट डू इट, एंड सो यू कीप ऑन ट्राइंग इट. सो वेन यू आर ट्राइंग इट, यू आर गेटिंग इट. बट देर आर पीपल आफ्टर मेनी ट्राइज ऑल्सो आर अनेबल टू गेट इट, दैट मीन्स समवेयर द एफर्ट आर बिकमिंग लेस. सो दिस इज समवेयर वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड एज नॉट एबल टू अटेन द हायर स्टेट. And when you see the next one, which says anavasti tattvani, what is anavasti tattva? After having attained, not able to sustain. Having attained the state of performing chirishasana, but you are not able to become steady in it, you are coming down, falling down. So, अब आपको ये खाली छोटे से एग्जाम्पल से समझ में आ रहा है. यू टेक द केस ऑफ योर मैनेजमेंट. A person doing lot of good tries, efforts to attain a higher post. उसकी काबिलियत नहीं है लेकिन वो कोशिश कर रहा है कि मुझे प्रमोशन मिल जाए, और उसकी कोशिश उसको प्रमोशन तो दिला देती है, बट वो प्रमोशन मिल जाने के बाद में ही इज नॉट एबल टू सस्टेन हिमसेल्फ इन दैट पोजिशन. वाई? बिकॉज ही इज लैकिंग द एक्चुअल एबिलिटीज टू गेट सस्टेन्ड ओवर देयर. सो इट नीड्स अ पर्टिकुलर टाइप ऑफ ट्रेनिंग. वन नीड्स टू गो थ्रू ए प्रॉपर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट एंड देन यू विल बी एबल टू सस्टेन यूर सेल्फ देयर. सम पीपल आर लक्की बिकॉज ऑफ द सिचुएशन और बिकॉज ऑफ द ब्लेसिंग्स ऑफ सम पीपल, दे डू अटेन सम स्टेट एंड रिमेन ओवर दैट, बट दे आरंट एबल टू परफॉर्म दैट वे. सो वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड ऑल दिस थिंग विथ दैट point of view of becoming an obstacle on the path of yoga. Actually, this chitta vikshepa, chitta means what? State of mind field, manaha, buddhi, ahankar. Vikshepa means what? A kind of distraction. So chitta vikshepa means causes of distractions of mind. Yes, Satosho sir.
Sthyana, vyadhis sthyana. So what is sthyana? Is, I have not understood sthyana.
Sthyana is mental laziness or dullness. Sthyana, vyadhi is disease. Sthyana is somewhat like, you know, mentally you are lazy. So dullness we call it actually, but to explain it more better, I am saying mental laziness. And that is where the alasya is also given in the nine. So that alasya word should be connected to the physical laziness. Let us discuss all these things in detail. We need to first understand that these are the obstacles which are causing mental distractions. And this antaraya, as they are better called, they continuously drag our mind externally. They do not allow us to go and become focused internally. They create a kind of, you know, जैसे हमने वृत्ति की बात की ना, कंटिन्यूस मॉडिफिकेशन इन द माइंड एंड डू नॉट अलाउ द माइंड टू गो टू द स्टेट ऑफ साइलेंस एज वी वेर डिस्कसिंग अर्लियर. वी ऑलवेज से दैट अ साउंड माइंड इन अ साउंड बॉडी. इफ द बॉडी इज सफरिंग फ्रॉम एनी डिजीज, फ्रेंड्स, वी ऑल नो हाउ डिफिकल्ट इट इज टू काम डाउन द माइंड. In our yogic journey, this body is like a vehicle. If the vehicle is getting any kind of problem, aren't we experiencing problems in reaching or rukavat in reaching our destination? The journey becomes tedious, hectic, problematic. I still remember a very good definition by the great Aurobindo. Unhone kaha, disease is an external manifestation of inner disorder. What is disease? Disease is external manifestation of internal disorder. So one way it is vyadhi, which is external. But when you take it as a balanced state of internal understanding, it becomes samadhi. So vyadhi and samadhi, you can take it as antonyms also sometimes. So vyadhi is like external manifestation and samadhi is like inner manifestation. So when we are going ahead with the integration of our overall personality as samadhi, then we should say disintegration of our personality as vyadhi. Pura bikhar jata hai na hamara personality. That is disintegration. That is vyadhi, friends. I got an understanding of Yoga Vashishta. This Yoga Vashishta is a text written by sage Valmiki. In that, he has explained a lot about vyadhi, adhija vyadhi, anadhija vyadhi, sara samanya. And he says this mental stress causes the disturbance of the prana in that pranamaya kosha, which in turn goes ahead and creates a lot of disorders in our system itself, in our organic functioning of the systems. So if we observe deeply, I need to make you all understand, we can easily find that our mind and intellect, they do not function harmoniously when we are in problems. Our thoughts, our feelings, our actions, they usually contradict. For example, if I say an intellectually, or I should say, all of us want to get up early, practice yoga, because we now know that how good it is for physical and mental health. But friends, in the morning, waking up early, we do feel the resistance from the mind. Kabhi kabar wo resistance ko mauka dena ek theek hai, chal jayega, lekin rozana nahi chalne wala. Intellect tells, get up and do yoga. Mind says, why not sleep and enjoy it a little bit more, thoda sa aur. Jaise bacche ko mummy uthati hai, time ho gaya school jane ka, uth, to bolta hai mama 1 minute. And aur itna sab jaddojahad se agar aap uth bhi jao, sometimes the body is reluctant to perform. This may be the case with us also. It has been with me, true. So what are we finding here? We are easily finding disharmony in the body, in between the mind and the intellect, in all the activities that we do. So friends, if there is a friction between the different levels of our personality, and if it is serious, and if it continues for a long period of time, it is going to result in diseases. And there are many reasons of such things, you know, tension at home or at office. Even such kind of simple, small tensions may lead to a kind of psychosomatic disorders. We need to understand how important is the practice of yoga and that quite right state of mind and body, a complex state, which can be made steady with the practice of asana, pranayam, mudras, whatever you say. The second one, as you asked, sir, sthyana, which I said dullness or mental laziness, you can say it literally means lack of mental strength, mental weakness. Is lack of mental strength. Generally, we are very enthusiastic in the beginning. But when we take up the work, and as the days pass, as the activities become repetitive, what happens to our enthusiasm? It gets weakened down. Here, yogic practices are really going to become very helpful. because they keep your enthusiasm up. So take note of that. Then the next one is Saushaya, doubt. Any kind of doubt in performance of any activities, even in yogic practices, is like a hurdle. Kya main kar sakta hu? This doubt itself is making you not able to do it. We have just finished Bhagavad Gita. Even the great Arjuna had a doubt. If one leaves all the worldly pleasures to attain the highest state, but dies before achieving it, is he not into the failure in this world? He asks. And when he is getting into the other world again, is it not that it is his failure? And yes, Lord Krishna answers him. He says, your auspicious deed never go waste. तुम्हारे कर्म अगर अच्छे कर्म है वो फलस्वरूप तुमको वही मिलेगा. अ योगी इज ऑल्सो कंटिन्यूइंग हिज जर्नी एट द सेम पॉइंट इन द नेक्स्ट लाइफ ही सेज. सो हाउ कम इट इज अ वेस्ट? वी ऑल्सो टू कीप दिस थिंग इन द माइंड. मेनी अ टाइम्स व्हेन वी आर रीडिंग टेक्स्ट वी कम टू डाउट्स. दिस इज द बिगेस्ट हर्डल in the progress of understanding scriptures, of having doubt. I still remember the understanding of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa when he left his body. Swami Vivekananda overtook the vrata, which was Parivrajaka vrata. He took up that initiative of traveling throughout the country. And as he was doing, once he came across one Baba who was in his state of meditation all the times. He used to remain in the remote cave without taking food. He could live only on prana. Swami Vivekananda stayed with him for several days. Then a doubt came to his mind. Who is my real guru? Whether it is the great Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, or now since I am experiencing this new learning from this Baba, I am not recollecting the name of that Baba. He is having understanding that whether he should get initiated from him. And this doubt made him very much restless for days. One day he sat in meditation with a firm resolve and he told himself, I won't get up from here till my doubt is getting dissolved. And after some time he had a very clear vision of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa ji. That just vision of Guru, of his Guruji, itself at once cleared his doubt that whom he should be having his as a Param Guru. So we all should go into that reflection state to clarify the doubts. Sometimes the doubt is because of our ego. Sometimes the doubt is because of our knowledge. Sometimes the doubt is because of our position. Sometimes the doubt is because of मैंने अच्छे अच्छे लोगों को पढ़े लिखे लोगों को इसमें देखा इस लाइन में. And in their lecture they say, I doubt. When they also doubt, that means they are not established. So here Patanjali Muni is very clear about this understanding that this doubt should be removed. It is one of the obstacle. Coming to pramada, carelessness you can say, or procrastination. Now see here, friends, performing day-to-day yoga without understanding its principle may prove very costly, huh? In pranayama, if one starts holding the breath, which we call as kumbhaka, without purifying the nadis, without doing the nadi shodhana, he may develop physical or mental disorders. Hatha Pradipika says very clearly, we have learned about it. Pranayamena yuktena sarva roga shayo bhave. Ayukta abhyasa yogena sarva roga samut bhava. The practical aspect of practicing pranayama. So yukta abhyas and ayukta abhyas should be very clear in us. So many a times, carelessness will lead us into ayukta abhyasa. Though you know the technique and everything, you have to be very careful. Step-by-step approach. Purification, as it is said, very essential. Aji hum pad rahe the about the three doshas. And it is said in Hatha Pradipika itself. First, you should get into the shatkarmas to make the three doshas balanced. And if they are balanced, then you need not do the shatkarmas. You can go ahead with the practice of nadi shodhana and get into the practice of pranayama itself. So pramada, carelessness, need to be understand where it some kind of, jaise ki hum kehte na ke kya roz roz sukshma vyayam karna hai, let me do directly today. So agar kabhi aap 3-4 saal se sukshma vyayam kar rahe hain, agar aap directly karne jaye to shayad aapko kuch nahi hoga. लेकिन एक दिन थोड़ा सा वो प्रमाद अगर आ गया सूक्ष्म व्यायाम करने का और आपने डायरेक्टली आपकी प्रैक्टिस शुरू कर दी आसन की, इट मे लीड टू प्रॉब्लम्स. तो लेट अस ओवरकम दिस केयरलेसनेस. नेक्स्ट इज आलस्य, लेजीनेस, और आई शुड से फिजिकल लेजीनेस, द तमोगुण एज एक्सप्लेन्ड इन अवर earlier in this sutra of abhyasa. Dirghakala nairantarya satkara asevito dridbhumi. Continuous practice without any break should be performed with all the enthusiasm, devotion, dedication. There is no substitute for hard work, friends. There is no substitute. Laziness has no place in yoga at all. Or in a yogic way of life, one should not know what is laziness. Of course, there are many other things which are responsible. And to overcome the other things, like, you know, having heavy diet is also a problem. Agar kabhi pichli raat mein aapne heavy khana khaya hoga, to uska asar aapko subah ke practice mein nazar aayega, dosto. So please practice moderation of diet. अगर आपके दोस्त बिरादर जो आपकी कंपनी है वो अगर कभी स्पिरिचुअल नहीं है, then remember, they will lead you into laziness. So company of ardent spiritual practitioners, जैसे कि हमारा एक ग्रुप बन गया, हम मोटिवेट हो जाते हैं एक दूसरे को सुनने से, बात करने से. इट ऑलवेज पंप्स अस. महेंद्र सर हैज सो मेनी टाइम टोल्ड अस कि मेनी अ टाइम्स ही इज बॉक्ड डाउन, बट आफ्टर सीइंग अदर्स एंड लिसनिंग टू अदर्स ही फील्स दैट एनकरेजमेंट, दैट एंथुसियाज्म, दैट ही शुड गिव इट अ बेटर स्टार्ट अगेन. हाउ दिस कम्स टू अस? बिकॉज ऑफ द कंपनी. सो लेट अस हैव सच काइंड ऑफ कंपनीज व्हिच इज रिमाइंडिंग आवर सेल्फ अबाउट द गोल टू बी अचीव्ड एंड ओवरकम दैट स्लॉथ, that laziness. So that is laziness which we should be avoiding always. And then comes the sixth one, avirati. Unable to become detached, that means attachment. These worldly objects and the thirst for the same drags us or drags our mind outwards. And as we have discussed this earlier also, suppression of the desires is always going to make the things worse. So here with determination, one should adhere to the regular practice. May be slow, as Mahendra sir many times say, I do slowly, I do according to my wish, I do not do all, but I do a few. Chalega, bahut achhi baat hai. Proud of you, sir. So there, slowly but surely, you are going to experience that ultimate blissful silence one day. It will automatically bring about, you know, the attenuation of the worldly attraction, you can say. So this avirati will be taken care of. Just as a fruit, friends. हम लोग वो मंत्र पढ़ते हैं ना, ओम त्रयंबकम यजामहे सुगंधिम पुष्टिम वर्धनम, उससे इन्फ्लुएंस होकर ये बात निकली, उर्वारुकम एव बंधनान. द वे द फ्रूट द ककुंबर व्हेन इट इज राइप ऑटोमेटिकली फॉल्स ऑफ द ट्री. इन द वेरी सिमिलर मैनर नॉलेज एंड द ब्लिस ऑफ द हायर स्टेट्स ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस विल एलिमिनेट द अटैचमेंट्स. So remaining in the knowledge is very important. और आज देखो हमने आयुर्वेद के साथ में भी शुरुआत की, कितना जरूरी हो जाता है ये सब चीजों को अपने स्पिरिचुअलिटी के साथ में कनेक्ट करना. And when we were going through that initial shlokas or sutras, we were understanding कि how important it is for us to know each and every minute things for us to become successful in yoga. Then the seventh one is Bhranti Darshan. The delusion part. Even if you are a yoga practitioner, sometimes you start having that feeling that you are having a extraordinary spiritual experience. ऐसा एक दिन एक बंदा आया और बोला, सर आपके टीचिंग से मैं इतना इन्फ्लुएंस्ड हो गया हूँ कि आजकल जब भी मैं अकेला प्रैक्टिस करता हूँ ना, तो मेरे बदन में से नीचे से ऐसा लगता है कि कोई करंट पास होते हुए ऊपर की तरफ जा रहा है. तो साबिर भाई को टेंशन आ गया, मैं इतने दिन से प्रैक्टिस करता हूं, मुझे कोई करंट का एहसास नहीं हो गया, इसको हो रहा है. आई टोल्ड हिम, मे बी यू जस्ट हैड ए सेल्फ हिप्नोटिज्म, यू मे बी जस्ट गोइंग थ्रू ए काइंड ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस विच इज नॉट रियल. Because he is saying that he is having a vision of that nad and bindu, anahad nad, jo hum hata pratipika mein pad rahe the. This itself may inflate his ego. He may start thinking that he has become a yogi. And this erroneous view, perception, or you can say a delusion, is a definite hurdle, friends. Isliye हमारा जो स्थान है ना, हमको वो स्थान से एक स्टेप नीचे ही रहना चाहिए हमेशा. आई एम फाइन हियर, ये जो भावना है वो आपको हमेशा ऊपर वाले स्थान से कनेक्टेड रखेगी. नहीं तो हम यहां पर है और हम उसके बारे में सोच रहे हैं, तो इट इज ऐसा ऐसा कि हम फुग्गे में हवा भरते हैं ना, वैसा हो जाएगा यहाँ पे. दैट शुड नॉट हैपन. एंड दिस एरोनियस व्यू should be observed in every aspect of our life. Okay, how we see the other person, are we becoming judgmental? That is an error. Maybe there is a delusion about our view about that person, and it becomes a problem. It becomes a distraction. Alabdha Bhumikatva is the next one. Non-attainment of the higher states. Years of practice, friends, and one is unable to attain the progress that you significantly want to experience on the path of yoga. When you are unable to attain it, one may be, you can say that one may be practicing meditation for years, but never experienced that silence or bliss, or even once he has not experienced it. So there are chances that one may give up the path itself. Aisa ho sakta hai. So what is preventing, friends? What is preventing him to experience? What is making him to give up the path itself? Actually, the impurities. the impurities which have been accumulated at different levels of our existence binds the consciousness to lower levels and we are unable to go up. और ये तो हमको भगवत गीता में भी पता चला कि this binds us down. काम क्रोध लोभ मोह, these are the षट रिपुस which pulls us down. These are the impurities. So how we can go beyond that? Faith, श्रद्धा. जैसे हमने सूत्र नंबर 20 में पढ़ा, श्रद्धा वीर्य स्मृति समाधि प्रज्ञा पूर्वक इतरेषाम. So faith and that devotion, that belief are the best means, friends, for such kind of spiritual aspirants who becomes stagnated on their path. They should keep on believing, hoga, hoga, 100% hoga. जितना उनको लगता है कि नहीं हो रहा है उतना उनका दृढ़ निश्चय बढ़ता जाना चाहिए. यानी सब्र की इंतहा हो गई ना, लेकिन फिर भी सब्र का पालन करना चाहिए. सो अलब्ध भूमिकत्व, दो इट इज अ स्टेट ऑफ नॉट एबल टू अटेन द अल्टीमेट स्टेट, इट्स ओके, यू कीप ट्राइंग. तपस्या जारी रहनी चाहिए. देन द नाइन्थ वन इज अनवस्थित तत्व, instability. After achieving that state of higher level, unable to sustain there, having achieved the state of, you can say, silence, you are not able to stay in that state for a longer time. You come back, or sometimes that silence comes and go away like a flash of light. You are unable to experience it for a longer period. So what is going to help? Continuous practice. Simple. Continuous practice is the only way to attain that stability. So vyadhi, sthyana, samshaya, pramada, alasya, avirati, bhranti darshan, alabdha bhumikatva, anavasthitatvani, chitta vikshepaste antaraya. These are the 9 obstacles. And you know, in the next sutra, which I think the time will not allow us to go at, but there are still 2 minutes. These are like the accompaniments. हम डी मार्ट में जाते हैं ना परचेस करने के लिए, तो देखते हैं कि किसके साथ में क्या फ्री मिल रहा है. तो हर जगह पे लिखा हुआ रहता है, 2 खरीदो तो 1 फ्री मिलेगा, 4 खरीदो तो 3 फ्री मिलेगा. तो समवेयर वी गेट मोटिवेटेड बाय दैट एस्पेक्ट आल्सो. तो पतंजलि मुनि हैज आल्सो सिमिलर कॉन्सेप्ट, मे बी नॉट सिमिलर कॉन्सेप्ट, जस्ट अ जोक, बट ही सेज इफ यू आर सफरिंग विद दैट दोस 9, दीस आर द 4 व्हिच कम्स टू यू ऑटोमेटिकली एज एकॉम्पनीमेंट्स. दुख दौर्मनस्य अंगमे जयत्व श्वास प्रश्वास विक्षेप सह भूवः. दुख पेन आशुतोष सर इज लिटरली एंजॉयिंग इट. सो दैट इज ट्रू सर. दुख सी व्हाट एवर इट मे बी, वेदर इट इज सर टेल मी.
I like your concept that if you have these, then the other things will come free.
Free. They are there. In fact, I should tell you that these are the symptoms that you are having. So, dukkha, the pain, dormanasya,